Hello everyone, Alex here from warrenoffkeys.com, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can debug Node applications using VS Code. If you don't already have a Node project, you can follow along. We're going to create a very simple application. I'm navigated into my console for within this project here, and I'm going to run npm init-y to initialize our project. And then we get this package.json file. I'm also going to make a new file here called app.js. And inside of here, I'm going to create a function called add. This is going to take a num1 and a num2. I'm going to console log. We'll say adding. And then I'm going to create a sum variable. So let sum equals 0. And then after that, I'm going to say sum equals num1 plus num2. Now, obviously, we could just declare right in here, but I'm writing this a specific way so you can see how the debugger works. And then we can return sum. Now, outside of our function, I'm going to create two constants. This will be called number one. This will be 5. Another constant called number 2, which will be 25. Then I'm going to create another constant. This will be called results. This could be called sum as well, but I want there to be two different names for the variables so it's very clear which one we're debugging. So constant results equals add number 1 and number 2. Then we can console log. We can say the sum is, and then we can concatenate the result onto here. Now, if I save this and I run this with node app.js, we then see adding the sum is 30 as expected. But let's say that there was a bug in here. Let's say for some reason we added an extra 1. If we were to run this again, we now get 31. And that's obviously incorrect because 5 plus 25 is not 31. So we could go through and try and find the bug. But let's say that this is a much more complicated application. Hypothetically, you could have a giant application where you don't necessarily want to search through all the code. That's going to take a lot of time. And so we can use VS Code's built-in debugger right here. If you click on this icon, you then get sent to a page like this. So from here, we want to click on create a launch.json file, and then we can click on node.js. Now within here, we have this configuration. We can skip certain files, but more importantly, we want to actually run our program from this. And this is assuming index.js. However, our main file is app.js. So we can change this to app.js and we can save. We can then close this. And if I expand this over a little bit, we see that we have some options here and we have this green start debugging icon. So I can go ahead and click on that. We can see that it ran through my code and it returned code 0, which means everything worked. I can actually go ahead and close out of this console now. We don't need it. However, we want to actually go through and debug this. So I'm going to set a breakpoint, which if you see this red dot here, when hovering over the line numbers, we can click on that right there. And that's going to set a breakpoint. Now, when we go to run this again, it is going to continue down the code just like normal, and then it's going to stop once we hit the breakpoint. So this line right here has not been ran yet. Now we might see a couple things pop up here. We see these variables here, and inside we can see our number one and number two variables that we have right here. We see our result variable, which is being declared right here, but it's not actually running the add function yet, so it's undefined at the moment. We also see this object right up here. Now this is something you can move around by clicking on the 6 dots. And these are the different controls for debugging. We can continue, which will then can run past the breakpoint right here. We can step over, which will then run the next line. We can step into, which will run the next function. In this case, that will actually go into add and start debugging there. We can step out, which will then, let's say that we're inside of add, it'll then go back to the code after we called it. We can restart the entire debugger, or we can stop it. So currently in our console, we don't actually see anything. But if I were to click step over, it's then going to run the add function, and then it's going to run this console log right here. So if I do that, we then see adding, and then afterwards, it's now waiting for us to do something else. So if I run this one more time, we then see the sum is 31 because this is now ran, and that's essentially the program is done right there. So we can go ahead and stop this. However, 31 is incorrect. So what we can do here is I'm going to run this again, and I'm going to then step into, which will put us into this function here. Now we see our local variables have changed because we're within the add function scope. And so we see num1, it's just 5, and num2, and these are our two parameters. We see sum, which is undefined, and this, which is undefined. So sum is actually going to be the actual result that we return. So I'm wanting to right click on this and click on add to watch. That's going to add its variable right here. Now if I click on step over, it's going to run the next line. And that simply just said adding in the console. So then I can step over again. And we now see the watch change to 0. So that's because the sum variable was updated because it actually ran this line. Now, if I do this one more time, we see the sum is 31. And so this is a bug here because we're expecting 30. So we can now look at the code and be like, okay, here's the problem here. We're adding an extra one. We can now get rid of this and we can rerun the program. And then we can click on step over. We see adding, step over one more time. We now see the sum is 30. So a real quick note is that if you're familiar with unit testing, which is something different, if you're not familiar with it, then of course that could be a better solution than what we're doing here. But this is just a very basic demonstration of how we can actually debug a very simple Node application using Visual Studio Code's debugger tool. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment down below or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord server and I'll try and get back to you when I can. And if you found this video helpful, then please consider liking and subscribing. Thanks for watching.